Thad Michael, I'm a naval architect at the Naval Surface Warfare Center Hard Rock Division at the Large Cavitation Channel in Memphis, Tennessee. It's a cavitation erosion test to measure cavitation at approximately full scale because we don't have any data like that. Ships go out to sea, they come back, we don't know what happened. There's no controlled testing. So this is the first of its kind controlled test to measure cavitation erosion intensity at close to full scale. We needed somewhere that you could achieve close to full scale speeds, and by that I mean 35 knots. And we also needed a place where you could install something large. And in this case, we have a foil that's 2.1 meters long, 7 feet. And that is roughly the scale of a rudder on a destroyer or a propeller blade. And so when we were approached about this project, we needed to complete it in a relatively short amount of time. And so we were looking for something that already existed. And the foil had been sitting here collecting dust for quite some time. So they dusted it off and shipped it up to Carter Rock. And at Carter Rock, they machined it to add places where we could install samples of softer materials. We needed softer materials because the nickel and bronze that the foil's made out of is one of the toughest materials for cavitation to erode. That's why we use it, you know, in our propellers at sea. And for this test, where we have a limited amount of time compared to the years that a propeller spends at sea, we wanted a range of materials so we knew we would see some erosion in a few hours to a few days, rather than the months that it would take with harder material. It's been challenging, but the team's really risen to the occasion and solved the problems as they come along. And we're glad to be up and running now, and finally we're getting data. It's very exciting. Because it is working. We filled all the sample locations with relatively soft aluminum because that was the thing we were most confident we'd see erosion on. The reason we put it in all the locations is because we want to verify that we're getting uniform distribution across the span of the foil. The foil is 10 feet wide and we have slots for, I believe, seven different span-wise locations. And because we're testing all these materials at the same time in different locations, the way we wanted to start out was by showing that all the locations are about the same. And we did discover that. So we're very happy about that. People are working very hard on this test, which is kind of normal when you come to the Large Cavitation Channel, because there's a lot of pressure by the time you get here, right, to produce results and to get things done, because we have a limited amount of time available. The team's done a great job. Everyone has their own strengths, whether it was all three organizations did simulations, but everyone had kind of their own niche. And then same thing when it came to materials and some of the preliminary testing. We had some material testing at Carter Rock. University of Memphis did some material testing. And then at the University of Michigan, they have a 14th scale model in a 14th scale facility. And that's a really unique opportunity for us to be able to test a scale model in a scale facility. That doesn't normally happen. And their testing was so useful because it showed us what type of loads we might expect here, which was a very important consideration because, as you can imagine, the loads here on our 10-foot by 7-foot foil are enormous. We've often collaborated, actually, with universities. And it's been a great opportunity for me because I've learned so much. We have so many opportunities to learn because we're kind of on the forefront of technology. We just don't do the same thing over and over again. We're always doing new things. That's what keeps it challenging and interesting for me. But I do know that the original high foil test was run by Carter Rock in conjunction with the University of Michigan with ONR funding. So there is some precedent for this.